Hello, welcome to the Thursday, March 11th, 2021 edition of the Sands and its Storm Centers Stormcast. My name is Johannes Ulrich, and today I'm recording from Jacksonville, Florida. Well, what's an attacker going to do after they got initial access to your network and are now trying to spread to different systems in the network? Classic tools that are often used, of course, are PS Remoting with PowerShell and PS Exec. However, defenders have heavily invested into detecting these tools, and attackers always are looking for a new trick to bypass some of these detection strategies. One protocol that's available to the attacker is RDP, and RDP does not necessarily mean that you set up a full GUI session to the remote system. The RDP protocol does allow for a lot more, like the simple execution of remote commands, and a tool, SharpRDP, takes advantage of this ability. Rob today wrote up a diary with a couple of quick examples how to take advantage of SharpRDP and, of course, also some defensive strategies how to protect yourself from attacks leveraging this tool. And well, if you're done patching all of your Exchange servers, all of your Microsoft DNS servers, and well, what else came up over the last couple of days, there is something new for you to patch, and that's F5. F5 released bulletins for 7 new vulnerabilities, 4 of which are rated critical. And 2 of the critical vulnerabilities do allow unauthenticated remote command execution. So something you certainly need to patch quickly. One is in the iControl REST and the second one in the Traffic Management User Interface or TMUI. We certainly have seen quite a bit of exploits against prior F5 vulnerabilities, so don't neglect them. Some of the mitigation here can be accomplished by just not allowing public access to these vulnerable interfaces. But it's not just F5 that suffers from unauthenticated remote code execution, it's also Netgear. Netgear did update the firmware for its Netgear Pro Safe switches, well, at least certain models that fix a number of vulnerabilities, one of which is an unauthenticated remote code execution vulnerability. There are also some authentication bypass vulnerabilities and unauthenticated firmware update vulnerabilities. Now, for a switch, the respective admin interfaces should definitely not be publicly accessible, and double check again that this is the case for your equipment. And talking about unsecured firmware updates, one ongoing problem has been how open source packages are authenticated. To solve this problem, Google and the Linux Foundation started a new project called SigStore. SigStore claims to become the Let's Encrypt for code signing certificates. Up to now, it wasn't easy and also a little bit expensive to actually obtain a proper code signing certificate. So SigStore is supposed to make this free and easy and is not just setting up the actual registry for these certificates, but also tools that should make it easy to interact with this registry and then sign your packages. Initially, they're going after packages, containers and such, but they are planning to expand this to additional use cases, like, for example, software bill of materials. One key feature of SigStore will also be certificate transparency. So all certificates being issued by SigStore will be logged to a certificate transparency log. That'll make it easy to, for example, set up alerts and the like to alert you of unauthorized certificates that are being issued. At this point, Six Store is still in development, so nothing really sort of set in stone or really not much to play with yet. But if you are developing and are publishing open source packages, you certainly should take a look at it and see if there's something that you would like to participate in. And well, this is it for today. So thanks again for listening and talk to you again tomorrow. Bye.